So in this part, we already finished all the previous parts, which are creating the components, the services, and also implementing the application guard. Now what we need to do is to add the routing. Here we have this file, the app-routing-module.ts, and inside this file we will define the routing for our application. And what is routing is like it simply is the navigation from one interface or from one page to another. For example, if I want to display the to-do list under this URL, I will just log in again. So here I'm logged. So in order to access this URL slash to-do list, all I need to do is to define a path or to define a new route with the path to-do list and which component will display this route. So for our case here, the to-do list is the to-do list component, which is this one. We already saw this before. And we have the can activate, which is how can we activate? So we can activate it using this user guard. And this user guard will determine if the user is logged in or not. If the user is not logged in, we will redirect him to the login. So here, for example, we have the to-do list. This URL for the to-do list is the to-do list component, and also for this part, the to-do list for my day for this component, it's also the same component. And as we saw here, we determine which parameter we receive in the path. And this is the start parameter, which is here. For example, if I say to-do list slash display slash today, here I will analyze it. I will check if it's today, so I will call the dedicated method to get all the information regarding this. For the to-do list slash new, it's the component create to-do component. And also I have the guard activated to all of them. Now, oh, here I forgot the guard. We can add it together. Here they can activate. It should be the user guard. Even to create or to update. Actually, the creation, create a to-do or create an object and update it can be done in the same component. So that's why here I'm using the same one. Let's do a quick check here and I will explain it. So here to resolve the to-do DTO, if I have the ID, I try to get it from the parameter or from the path. If I have the ID, so I will get the to-do by ID, else I will do nothing. If in case of error, I will just call this cancel method, which will redirect me to the to-do list. So this is quite easy and simple. And the same for the categories, the new create new category and update for the user profile. And I do not have a guard for the login and the subscribe because I don't need a guard because in the login, the user can log in. Or can create in the subscribe can create a new profile, or he can sign up in the application. So this is the routing, and this is really a simple task. You can do it for every time you add a new component, or every time you want to navigate or create a new page. You can just directly go and do it on the fly. You add the new path, and you can test it directly on the fly without waiting to create all the components and then adding the routing at the end.